Today on Kwibuka Podcast, we hear details of massacres of Tutsi Adventist pastors and their families at the Seventh Day Adventist Church headquarters at Gitwe. Although they first started to arrive at the church on April 18, 1994, the first major attacks was on May 20, 1994. On the same day, over 470 women and children were killed at Douane in the current Ruhango District. May 20th, 1994. Massacres of Seventh-day Adventist Tutsi pastors at Gitwe. Massacres of Tutsi women and children at Douane in Ruhango District. About 74 Seventh-day Adventist pastors and their families were killed in Gitovu on May 20th, 1994. Gitovu is in the former Gitarama Prefecture, Murama Commune in Nkomero Sector, now in Nyanza District, Sector of Michingo in Nkomero Cell. The Tutsi pastors of the Seventh-day Adventist Church and their families fled to Gitwe because there was a headquarter of the church called Field, and they hoped to be protected and saved. Some of them did their pastoral work there and hoped they would not be betrayed by their fellow Hutu pastors. They also felt that the killers would not dare to kill them at the church headquarters. Others from Masango, Tamge communes in Ruhango, and Nonge commune in Nyanza and elsewhere joined them. The first group arrived on April 18, 1994, and others kept coming to seek refuge there. They were killed on May 20, 1994, after spending a whole month as refugees at the church headquarters. They had all gathered in the church, as families kept on coming to seek refuge at the church headquarters. Only a few pastors and their families, as well as some church teachers, were allowed to enter. Others, including Ezra Kajaguhakwa, who lived in Buhanda and was a member of the church, were sent away. Life at the church was difficult. The Adventist church provided them with very little food support in comparison to their large number. Ordinary citizens and fellow Christians from the neighborhood did not supply them with anything. The little additional food support they got was from Tutsis, also in hiding, in the surrounding areas. On May 19, 1994, a day before they were slaughtered, Hutu pastors from different parts of the countries held a meeting at the church headquarters at Gitwe. The meeting was attended, among others, by treasurer of the church, Solomon Mayamaguru. On May 20th, 1994, all those who had sought refuge at the church were taken to Nkomero in Gitovu, where they were executed to avoid the shame of killing them at the church headquarters. Before taking them to Gitovu, the killers first shot the pastor, Ziyad Nzamwita, who lived near the church headquarters and had remained in his house with his family. He was shot by one of the gendarmes who had come from Nyanza to set an example for the rest of the killers. The Tutsi refugees were taken in a car that belonged to a parents' association school called ASEPAG, École Secondaire de l'Association des Parents Adventistes de Gitwe. They also used a Hilux pickup truck belonging to Buzizi Gratien, who was a businessman living in Nkomero. A third car belonging to a Tutsi pastor, Amondru Jirinyanje, who was a leader at the headquarters and had fled to Ruhango, was also used. On their way to Gitovu, they were singing a song called We Are Going to Zion. They were taken by the burgomaster of Murama commune, Rutiganda Jean Damasen, together with the gendarmes from Nyanza. They had come to Gitwe after killing women and children at a place called Douane in Murama commune. Upon arrival in Nkomero, a large number of Hutu civilians had gathered at the foot of Gitovu Hill and had been armed with traditional weapons, awaiting to kill Tutsi refugees from Gitwe. The refugees were slaughtered using traditional weapons, including clubs, axes, machetes, etc. As some of the Hutu civilians were busy killing, others were burying the bodies in the trenches. The killings took place in the presence of the burgomestre and the gendarmes who had surrounded the refugees. Some of those involved in the killings included Damasen Rutiganda, the former burgomestre of Murama commune, who was sentenced to life imprisonment in absentia. Eras Tugirasebuja, a pastor in Gitwe, sentenced to 19 years in prison before he fled. Solomon Mayamaguru, a treasurer of the church who was sentenced to 19 years in prison but now lives in the Philippines, and Charles Mujenzi, a driver of ASEPAG, who also fled the country. There are also gendarmes from Nyanza and the Interahamwe militia. A genocide memorial site in Gitwe serves as the final resting place for the pastors and their families who perished in the genocide against the Tutsi. At Douane, on May 20, 1994, about 476 women and children were killed. Men and boys had already been killed. Douane is located at the former Gitarama Prefecture, Murama Commune, Bgeramana Sector in Rugwavuningoma Cell, which is currently in Ruhango District, Bgeramana Sector, Murama Cell, and Gasharu Village. The Tutsis who had fled to Douane were from different sectors of Mrama commune, especially in Mgeramana sector. Others were from Masango and Kigoma communes of Gitarama Prefecture. Some of them had first fled to the Nyabitari Adventist Church in Mrama commune, but left after the church had been attacked. They had taken refuge there because there was no other secure place in the area. They had initially wanted to seek refuge at Mrama commune offices, but they were warned that they could be killed there. Finally, they decided to flee to Douane and were hiding in unfinished houses belonging to Rukara. As they had arrived at different times, some of them had already spent almost 2 weeks at Douane, living in harsh conditions with their young children. They begged for food supplies from those of them who could reach their fields unharmed, mainly those who are not hunted. They were also eating guavas from the nearby trees and being supported by a few neighbors. Still, it was not enough. Out of fear, some of the refugees were spending their days hiding in the bushes and joined others in the house when it was raining or at night. On May 20, 1994, an attack was launched by Jean Damascene Rutiganda, the former burgomaster of Mrama commune. He was accompanied by gendarmes from Nyanza, Interahamwe militia, and other killers from the general public. Before they were killed, the burgomaster had lied to them that he had come to hold a meeting to help find food supplies for those who had been hiding for a long time. This made even those who were hiding in the bushes come out and join the others. As soon as they entered into the house, Interahamwe militia and other killers began slaughtering them using traditional weapons while the gendarmes surrounded the house. After the killings, the bodies were dumped in holes that had been dug while making bricks for the construction of the house, which was serving as refuge. The bodies of the victims were later laid to rest in the Nkomere Genocide Memorial. The massacres were led by a burgomaster of Mrama commune, Rutiganda Jean Damascene. He was also joined by gendarmes from Nyanza and the president of MRND in Mrama commune, Ndungutse Anatole, who was also the inspector of schools in Mrama commune. He was sentenced to life imprisonment and died in Nyanza prison. Ndungutse was a brother to the infamous Interahamwe called Sekamonyo, who was sentenced to life imprisonment and also died in Nyanza prison. There are also other members of the Interahamwe militia like Munya Nyindi Augustin and Ngofero. The two were sentenced to life imprisonment and are serving their jail terms in Nyanza prison. Thank you for listening to another episode of Kwibuka Podcast. As always, make sure you leave us a review, sharing what you like about the podcast, and share with others who would be interested in listening.